Let's check this one, please. Nice, it'd be echoing around back and forth, brilliant. Okay, brilliant, so let's have a look here. So hello and welcome guys to a new stream, even though this is not the planned stream, not at all, won't be long as well. So in this stream, just going to actually record things for my next or one of the upcoming videos. So that's pretty much the only reason. And as you can see, we're sending off a refueling SST. Brilliant. The only thing I do want to add, however, still is maybe an additional docking port. I think we actually have one inside here, if I remember correct. No, we don't. We don't have an additional docking port inside here. Okay, let's then take you off. Place the RTGs in onto this side of the hull, and take an inflatable airlock here. This way, we have a secondary option to dock this craft with. Brilliant. Close RCS should be working. They've got some RCS in there. I would actually love to bring in a coop as well. Prolonging this here would look ridiculous, I know. Hello, hello, and welcome to the stream, Sergeant Matrix. Like the description says, this is a really relaxed stream. Nothing too serious, since I actually planned on recording a video. Anyways, so I decided to, why not just show how I'm streaming, and by the way, the streaming software is a bit different, as you can see here. You can actually see my YouTube studio page and things. So, yeah. It's a bit of a different stream, not like the way I usually do it. That's why we've got also some music in the background, not quite sure how... Just let's fly to the moon. Well, actually, this thing is not supposed to go to the moon, to be frank. But we can go for a test flight. That's actually not a bad idea. I think I've done one test flight into LKO only. But why not? Yeah, I mean, why not? It's not a bad idea, frankly speaking. Refill SSTO to the moon, that's fine. But I'm still thinking about adding some sort of crew compartment. But one ton of these guys, that's just too much. Adding these two here. So I do want to have some crew and board, just for crew, how it's called? Crew control, you know? Since the goal of this thing is to go to Lathe. To go to Lathe and, well, literally that's Lathe SSTO. And since I haven't thought about that yet, and Lathe, brilliant. Oh well, that seems reasonable. Good, that's fine. So let's go for a quick test flight and double checking quick deaction groups. This is bouncy. Center of mass. Well, the center of mass should be in front of the center of lift, and I was placing the rear landing wheel east on purpose so far in the front that the center of mass is right approximately here where my cursor is right now. That's a good question, whether it will fly. I think yes. Brilliant! Alright, very keen on actually, since I've built this a couple days ago, I haven't built it right now. It's very good actually. Question is whether we'll have enough thrust to gain enough speed. That's something we'll have a look at right now. What's the mass actually of that contraption? 160 tons by. Mmm. 12. 1400. That's a bit over the top. And weight for rapiers actually. Let's remove this one and trim it down. Trimming is a nice thing for SSTO flights. These two obviously are not working because, well, they are nuclears. We will only engage them once we are in space. And this is also something I'd like to try out, actually, by the way, right now. Whether with only two nuclear engines for a 150 ton based are enough to lift it in, well, to get it into orbit in time. I think yes, but like I said, I haven't tried it. Yes, exactly, they're made for space the way you say it. Very high ISP, 800 seconds. We're not quite equatorial, that's a bit of an issue, but not too biggie. And in terms of thrust, things are looking very good. I'm trimming even further down, I mean, which is our third trim. To keep it more or less on prograde. And we're accelerating soon past 400 meters per second. Now we can reduce the trim and go up. 400. Quickly having a. Well, the other thing is, in low altitude you're getting more speed out of the, well, more air to get speed for the rapier, since they really are air hungry. And now we're gaining altitude. So I only want to pitch up and gain altitude once we've reached more than 400 meters per second, and now it's just in a natural climb. You'll see it will probably pitch down at 16 kilometers. Max Q, yeah. Now let's pitch down a bit, otherwise we will shoot out of the atmosphere way too early. Let's have a look. So you don't want to go above the 20-kilometer mark, actually, or just yet at least, without gaining over, what is it, say 1500 meters per second at least. We're a bit too high for my account. Let's keep this one. Was not a good approach, flight plan. We were shooting too fast up. Now we're losing a lot of thrust up here. You have, okay. Because in the previous test that I can remember, it went actually pretty well. Now we're slightly losing altitude, that's okay. And we're picking up more thrust, waiting until we get, what is it, 1500-ish. We're using a lot of fuel. Yeah. More liquid fuel would be probably good. Now we're going up again, you see? Without me doing anything. I haven't pressed any key binding or anything. So now it's looking... We should not probably accelerate... Good. I'm going just to keep it slightly above the center of the prograde marker. Oh no, wrong button, sorry, shit. Wait, which one was the added action groups? Three. Oh, it was three. Oops, my bad. I wanted to just to activate the nerves, actually. There you go. You usually shoot up vertically. You should try to get as much speed out of the air breathing mode, so that's why I'm trying to go for 20 kilometers. And they're accelerating as flat as possible until 1500 meters per second. Now we've got just a low thrust to weight ratio with the only two nerves. That's kind of a bad thing about this craft. 3, 2, 1. Switching over. I'm trying to shoot the periapsis up. The entire goal of that thing is anyways to go into lathe orbit and back. So if we can get into LKO, it already kind of more or less succeeds with its mission design. Forty kilometers up, perhaps is brilliant. Even faster. Yes, of course, but that's not kind of the way of SSTO is supposed to do it. And 70, brilliant. Let's have a look at our... We have a lot of oxidizer left in comparison, actually. for almost too much. So you could get rid of a couple of oxidized tanks, I presume. Because now it's just this one just waiting. We have 80 kilometers of apoapsis. There you go. And waiting. Not yet, we are, as you can see, well, if we go quickly into map view. Suborbital. 80 kilometers here. Way too many lines, let's get rid of the relay arrays. Watch here. Return sample. Oh. Okay. Da-da-da-da. So now we are actually in... Let's compress 5, opening up the cargo bay. Just to check something. Yeah, you're completely full. So, like, that's, like I said, one of the goals is having this one completely full. And now we're about to hit apoapsis, so let's engage our nuclear engines. Time warping! And here you can see the periapsis down here. And... there are not enough RCS thrusters, is something I just realized. There are no RCS thrusters in the back here. Okay, and... there you go, 70 kilometers. So we're orbiting now. Let's have like liquid fuel apart from this. We have 2,000. Let's go like that. Like this. That's by no way correct. Anyway, let's go and try this one out anyways. Let's go for a quick save. Well, it's approximately the way. Yeah, that should be fine. That's an 11 minute burn, we definitely have to split this in two. Okay, on to the periapsis. That's a bit too late, frankly speaking. Anyways. We close it again, thank you. Just wanted to see if everything's alright there. We have, I say, I'm pretty sure we'll have. The biggest problem, or what I'm really afraid of the moon, is that we don't have enough thrust to weight ratio. Because with two nuclear engines, we'll never have enough thrust to weight. And our oxidizer, yeah, the thing that I'm more or less counting on here is that we're just going to use the tank here. Going to test this out, but anyways, the idea of this one is anyways to go down to Lathe, and there we've got an atmosphere, so we don't care about we don't care about anything thrust weight related, because we have then all the engines working on liquid fuel only. That's just... I've got enough, thank you. Um, Oh wait, before we do that, actually, let's just wait a bit more for the next pass through here. Then I want to see something. Okay. If we remove this one. 2,000 meters per second? Yeah, that's enough. In theory. Oh, wait, we don't need this one anymore. Well, I think you have seen my moon base. Or do you mean the orbital base? There should be videos for both of them out on the channel. Guess one more pass and then we'll hit target. Oh, now we're too late in with going for that. Let's just quickly tap this one. I've never seen it outside of... Oh, okay. Now I understand what you mean. Maybe don't you think we'll actually visit it, since it's on the pole and landing on a pole with 4 SSJ is not worth... Well, it's not that good. And no, it won't be a good encounter, will it? We actually go. Okay, that was bad. Shouldn't have done that. We should have planned things a bit. T-minus 72 days. Well, whatever. Let's just be like, we're up here. There, stop it. Stop doing everything. I'm not quite sure where I should actually burn. That's definitely the wrong way. That's nice, isn't it? 11 km, like 9 kilometers. Okay, that's... Ready, Lynn. No, no crush. Come on, where's the... Just getting nice and close. Oh, you have done this one yet. So, come on, point towards the radial in. They're getting this nice and close. I wish I had now a fuel drain. Then could drain some of the excess oxides and gain some more delta V. That's good. Da-da. Well, we definitely need more of the RCS thrusters. Just flying here through, waiting until we hit orbit. Then we can actually try landing on the polar base. Set as target. Just for you! Going for the polar base! Let's have a look here. Ba-ba-ba-ba. Brilliant! I just hate having to look at the poles. Just don't have this. Let's have a look. How fast can we warp around? Waiting a bit. Approximately until the base is over here. I don't know why it's wobbling around like that. Let's stop it. A bit more. Few orbits more. Stop it. I'd say three. Whoa, that was a bit much. Is it like literally on the pole? Okay, we're not in a perfectly sort. Well, whatever. I don't care. Let's just deorbit right now and figure the rest out on the way down. We should be able to do that. Preferably, we actually have to. Let's have a look here. Let's just bring down the. Burn up a tiny bit. It is actually looking not too bad. Let's make it like this. Wait, why don't we have control? Because one of the bloody things is now offline. It's giving me my satellites. It's of course on the dark side of the moon. Brilliant. Let's wait until we get connection with the satellite. Now we have, okay. And let's go for the next orbit. That seems reasonable. If we go and make a dead stop like there, should be able to land. Okay, so go to warp to next maneuver. Oh, the last one's opened up still. Oopsie. Seems like this was not into. I clicked and probably clicked it with right click, closed the other bay, and then forgot that we have a second one here. So let's go full power and do that. You don't have a maneuver node thingy. Well, thanks for that. We really need more satellites around the moon in that case. Yeah, we don't have any Kerbals, that's kind of a bummer. That's why I actually wanted to have my crew cabins with us, but I forgot to smack some Kerbals into those crew cabins. Okay, now let's go for. Mike, let's get rid of this thing. Let's just force it. I don't care. We have enough fuel. There we go, now we're suborbital. Now we can go for... just landing close enough to this thing and we'll have connection, that's all I care about. You have to turn around by 200 degrees approximately, so that this is down. Good. Yeah, let's just make it time warpy warpy. And that should be enough. Okay, brilliant. And I think we should go burn this way, but that's just my personal intuition. I've no clue whether this is correct in terms of direction wise. Okay, now that seems reasonable, that's correct. We need more RCS thrusters. What do you mean, update the game? What version are you playing on? That will be it's a rather annoying inclination change, if I may say so. Wasting a lot of oh, look at that, how beautiful curb and rise. That's definitely worth a screenshot there. Brilliant, and here we have our polar base coming in. Brilliant, boy, that's nice. And we're about to be on target with the polar base. Polar base on target, check. Point retrograde. Well, actually, let's go for radially out a bit. I'd like to fly over the thing first. Look at that, how beautiful that is. Okay, good. Now we should be flying just a tiny bit over the base, I presume. We'll see. Let's go for a quick save here. If we're not going to land in the first time. K-Rise, exactly. Oh, rip. Yeah, you should definitely. It has a lot of performance increases, actually. So, it's even better for not high-end PCs. Like, regular commercial grade. So... no, don't give me target, give me servers, please. So, I went, like I said, I went to slightly overshoot it. And well, this is looking very bad, so that's why we're going to use our Rapier engines, and that's why we will have enough fuel, I hope. Even though our fuel goes down really fast, I'm assuming. There you can see the liquid fuel. Oh, we'll be actually rather close if I say so. 600, we are 300 meters up. We have just too much oxidizer. And that could have been beautiful. And let's make a dead stop pretty much here. That looks good. Exactly. This is polar base. Yeah, it will be a rather hard landing, and it was actually regularly, well, landing a regular lander slash rocket was already hard. So, oh, look at this. Beautiful, boy. And we're burning at full thrust and we're not losing any speed almost. You've got 100 plus, you've got 120 sprint. Give me altimeter and not sea level. 700 meters, brilliant. Give me another quick save, please. Oh, you cannot quick save while about to crash. Well, we are not about to crash. Just as a small information, we're still not about to crash, if I may say so. But that might be just me being overconfident, too much confidence here. I need to search for a flat spot for my bases so further missions can get. Yes, but the idea for this base was not for further missions, but the NASA mission to the moon, to the real moon, going to the poles in search of water. But that was a bit too much thrust, my bad here. No, we broke a tip of our wing. Oh no, that's not good. Okay, so it's not a crash, but we broke a tip. So it's time for a reload. Because, well, we need the wingtip, right? We need a bloody wingtip in order to... Where are we? Yeah, really, really far away, actually. Surface. Oh, that's a bit close. A bit fast. Nice maneuvering here, looking fancy. You know. Let's go for quickly out of this one. Give me, please, actually. Oh, it's already recording. Brilliant. Everything's going perfectly according. At least it's not an impact, right? Well, let's just make this landing even better. And dead on, like on target. You can see already the light if you look down here. You can see the light. Brakes up, gear going down. Give me just one rotation so that we're going to look towards that thing. And let me tell you, let me guess, we cannot quick save because we're about to crash. Yeah, exactly. And how about now? We're flying up and you don't. That's not good. This new change that you cannot quick save just prior to landing is annoying, and there we have Kerbin. Let's remove these ones, please. Give me one again. Going to make it a bit more aggressive. Not aggressive, more suicide burn like. We're going this way. Okay, just the fact that this is a bloody hill right in front of us. I don't know if you can see it, because that here it goes down by a lot. So let's make a slow pass over the base. There we go, nice slow pass over the base. And now coming in for a nice touchdown. No, it goes down! Look at that! Look at that, it goes down here. Oh, and it's like literally on the... Oh no, my goodness, on the mountainside, or hillside at least, which is literally touched them perfectly on the hillside. Perfect, brilliant. Now, let's get rid of that and remove brakes. Don't go too fast, please. Let's remove these ones as well, please. Let's go just nice and slow up the mountain. Okay, good. Touchdown. Brakes, 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 and turn. Now, one thing that I have learned after landing already these two crafts here is... Come on. Quick saving. There we go. That's one of the most important things while trying to run around here. Well, before we will be ready for launch, we have to open up the cargo bay. Oh, it is actually clipping through the landing gear. That's not good. Ah, things to improve next time. Increase our braking force a bit here. Now I'm going to roll with... There you go. It's not centered, the camera. Be like, nice and slowly, cozy, going towards the base. Hello and welcome to the stream, Gaming Below Zero. Just bringing our SSTO nice and close to the polar base on the moon. And because it's going downhill here, I'm already tapping the brakes. Got rid of brakes? Perfect. Wait, we could in theory try to dock with it, could we? I think it's too low actually. No, that's not going to work. But we will go now and zoom in here and deploy the drill. And extend the ladder. Wait, have we got anything up? Yes, there we go. Opening up. Well, this one should be to open up as well. Having this antenna now. And now we can just start service harvest. And you can be start using liquid fuel. And now it's just... Perfect, right? So, I'm just going to have a look now at the comments. Well, we could try to refuel at the moon base, since you can see over there it has, well, an ISRU itself and a fuel tank. But I think, well, it would be really tedious trying to dock them if it's actually possible, since this docking port is a bit higher than this one here. Neither Picard from Star Trek to Major Paul Brilliant. Yes, of course you were mentioned in this stream. Everybody gets mentioned. How to land a surface base on the moon. Go into the VAB and then press... Where is it? This little tab, the Delta V icon that you have in the VAB on the lower right corner. And then select... on the upper hand side, kind of in the thing, instead of Kerbin, Moon, and then you go into your staging on your right side, since you're in the VAB, and have a look at your thrust to weight ratio is over 1. I would actually suggest for landing 2, since this makes it a lot easier. You have enough thrust to abruptly slow down yourselves in order to not crash into the bloody ground, otherwise you're just going to make another crater. We don't have enough fuel yet, so let's continue time warping. next up. Oh yeah, Sergeant Matrix. The thing is, like I said in the very very beginning, this SSTO is actually designed, but it failed in that regard. I think, yeah, it failed. We need more fuel for that. I actually want to bring this kind of thing or something close to this to lathe in order to refuel. Well. Land on lathe, refuel it, and then go into low lathe orbit, which we are totally capable of doing, and then refuel any ships around lathe, or Joule in general. So that's the idea. So that's why we have this big orange, let's go back here, this big orange tank was in the beginning like that, kind of locked so that the fuel would not drain from it. So, and that's why I brought obviously ISRU with me, since otherwise we'd have to do the same thing as in the previous stream. So in the previous stream, if you go into my YouTube channel, you can see we send a small surface base to the to Minmus and an SSTO. So the surface base is like mining and refining, all like pretty much similar like this one, just in one construction and not in two launches, since this was built and constructed on the surface, this one here. So polar base to the moon. You can go and have a look at one of these of that that video on the channel page. And like I said, there we went with the SSTO, docked to the base on Minmus, and refueled the SSTO. And in theory, we could go wherever we want now. Pretty much apart from two, it's a small SSTO. I frankly can't remember exactly how much delta we've had. So go and have a look at the video. There's a highlight video there. Next up, what we've got here, portable. It depends on which planet. Yes. Just to the moon. Yes, for the moon. Small size rockets. Yes, exactly. Yeah, like Sergeant Matrix said, small rockets for landing on the moon are more than enough. For example, if you have the DLC, use the. No, how are they called? Not Thud. If you don't have the DLC, use the Thud engines. Those wide. Sideways mountable engines. If you have the DLC, use those Soviet ones with 40 degree gimbal. They are brilliant. You know what, let's actually, do we have enough? No, we need just a bit, or I would like to have at least some more fuel than this, just to be on the safes. Otherwise, well, 1,000 units are actually enough to get back. Yeah, wait. I have an idea. Let's quickly jump over to the. Wait, the base has no. Oh, the base is unstaffed yet. That's something we should have done. There's a couple more days on the timestampy thingy. Let's have a look. Sky crane. Oh yeah, well, a sky crane. Actually, these two. I think one of them at least had something. Sky crane live, but not sky crane, but just on the sides, and then detach them. And then I drove them with this small rover here in the front, kind of both together, and stick them together since the docking ports are on the same height. Let's have a look. Just build your base on top of a rocket. Yeah, just make it out a land like the lowest part of your detachable stage of the rocket payload stage. We'll just have some landing legs. You land it like a lander and just don't take off, and then you have a surface base. Check. Sky cranes are fun. Yeah. Okay, so now back to the thing here. That's enough time warping. I've had enough. Oh wait, we should actually do maybe a screenshot, you know, like SSTO to surface. Wait, can we see Kuba? No, we can't, right? It's too high up. Oh, am I looking in the wrong direction? Ah! Looking in the wrong direction, brilliant. Yeah, it's just a tiny bit too high. Nah! Yeah, we're too low. We can just see it on the very, very edge there. But if we go down here, we can't see it, sadly. So let's just make one screenshot here. Right, wrong button there. No, there we go. And now let's have a look. Or let's have a think, rather. We want to go looking at Kuban left 90 degrees. So in order to go left, pretty much the opposite way compared to where we are. So let's remove our brakes, turn around. Let's have a look. This will definitely not be very, how's it called? No, that's Kerbin. So Kerbin is straight from here. So we'd go 90 degrees. Is that 90? No, that's 45. That makes no sense because this should be 90. Anyways, we'll be able to figure out the small details during our ascent. Just stop here. The world's not perfect, but not that bad. Okay, quick saving and... Wait, there's no comment. Glorified Landis. A fuel pump. Whoa, that sounds nice. I think this is actually the first base that I have constructed out of multiple sections on the surface. Because usually I just build them and then land them as one thing. Maybe like one of the other stations that I haven't shown on the YouTube channel was where I've made like an orbital station, dock it in orbit or during the descent, well, still in space, and then just landed everything like docked together and everything, and then just make a nice touchdown. This is the first time I was trying around with rover wheels and docking them like that. Anyways, we are going. Taking off. Oh, we should actually maybe retract this one. Oopsie. Retract drill. And maybe pitch up a bit more, otherwise we're going to crash like my previous Moon SSTO. Which, well, it didn't crash, it just lost one engine. So go and have a look at Mark 3 Moon SSTO on the channel as well. There are a bunch of videos like that. Let's have a look here. It looks actually perfect. Oh, looks pretty good. We're just flying totally into the wrong direction, but that's all. Okay, yeah, I managed to go into the wrong direction. Brilliant, that's just skills. Now let's give us one more nice boost with the ray piece. There we go. And look at that. That's just a... I'm not moving the camera at all. Hands off keyboard. That's just beautiful shot, isn't it? That's a beautiful shot with those ridges right on the pole. That's the pole, my friends. That's like literally the pole. That's beautiful, brilliant. That was worth having a look at that. So we're like 13 kilometers or something. The base is like 13, 14, 15 kilometers off the pole. Need a bit more altitude again. Yeah, we go back home. What do you think would have destroyed the ship? Oh, you mean crashing probably. I accidentally plugged out my microphone. The reentry capabilities. Well, yeah, that's something we will have a look at. So we're just about to hit orbit. So the periaps is coming up there, just slightly underneath the surface there. Just wait until we're at apoapsis. You could get destroyed. Jet capsules for entry. Wings tend to break. Yeah, aerodynamic stress. Let's get another. Right, that's the wrong button. Oopsies. and time for circularization. And our plans, well, we're going to accelerate on the North Pole for orbit, for not orbit, but for the escape burn. Space Shuttle 12Co. Well then, you should maybe have a look at one or two of my SSTO guides, or videos in general. And we can go, and yep, I can see that's not the perfect. Ah, whatever. By the way, what do you guys think about having some music like that in the background? Just... And we can actually close our gizmo thingies. And come on. You like it? Brilliant. That's good. Come on, when will... There we go, we are escaping. That's a terrible escape vector. But I don't care, we have enough... We should have enough fuel to go then. Just going to do one additional round. Well, orbit in that case. To apoapsis. Well, 3,000 meters per second speed, brilliant. Now give me orbital speeds, please. And... Rapier, since we have enough fuel. There you go. Maybe a bit more rapiering. Come on, give me the rap... No, it don't work. Want to work here? There we go, let's have a look. Periapsis, let's go the rest with nucleus just to have a look. More control over the descent. We're going to do a couple of passes, don't worry guys. Okay, maybe a bit faster like this. And 100 kilometers, 70, 60, we'll go for 50 for first pass. 55, that's good. Quick saving if we burn up because, well, I don't know, unlucky. And next up is... Falling down towards the blue marble. There you go. And that's it. Inducing a nice spin here and removing SAS and do nothing. Perhaps is coming down. It is flipping around, that's not that good. Let's stop the flip, I don't like flippies. There we go. Out of the atmosphere, and in we go for the second. No, we don't. We are way, we are high enough so that nothing happens. Give me my this altitude again. And here. Let's have a look. Spaceman, if fuel is not enough, we'll wander in outer space for winter. No, no, we have enough fuel, don't worry. Oh, thank you very much, Gaming Below Zero. I would really appreciate getting more views, subscribers and everything, but, you know, as a small YouTube channel, it is rather hard, or it's actually very difficult to attract new people, since I'm trying to go around in Reddit, Discord, and sometimes, if people are searching for help or asking for some advice or something, I usually tend to, well, obviously give nice advice I can give, kind of, and at the same time I'm trying to link down an example video, like for example, someone's asking how to build an SSTO, then I go and be like, okay wait, how about you have a look at, I would do this, this and this improvement, if you want any kind of inspiration, here's my SSTO video playlist. And then some people will decide and have a look at it, and maybe they subscribe. So that's more or less the way I've been doing it in a couple of the past three-ish months or something. So yeah, but more than that, getting more subscribers apart from this is rather difficult. I mean, I don't really know how else I could improve the reach of my videos, since I'm doing tags and thumbnails and everything. You know, if you go and have a look, how to increase the growth of your YouTube channel, the things that people say like in every second video is add more tags, do some custom thumbnails. That's like both things I've been doing from the very, very start, so I don't know what else I could do to improve. And you know what, let's just do some aggressive maneuvering, since we are not losing enough altitude anymore, and I want to have less altitude, so just make it like that and disable SAS. Well, we can actually have SAS, doesn't matter, we have more than enough electricity, and just turn around. This way we'll lose more velocity, and that's what we want to. We'll soon drop below 300, don't worry. Altitude 70, good. Dun, 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 dun. And give me just a tiny adjustment in our altitude, actually. Going to slow down a bit. There you go, 44. That's fine. Let's have a look how this will go. I think this will be no issue either. The first pass, right, a bit more careful. I'm totally fine. That's very good. In that case, we're going up again. Give me no SAS and pitch down. This way we do more drag. And back to the app we're accessing. Is it actually bright enough for you guys on YouTube? I think it's a bit too dark. Give me quickly. Increasing the brightness. Where is it? Gamma, 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 ambient light boost. That's a bit too much probably. Apply. Now it's a bit brighter, I think. So you can see we're below, just above 3,000 meters per second. Let's pitch down and reduce our velocity more. That's good. There's a big crater lake, or sea, or bay, or whatever, with the nice island in the middle. Well, it's okay, we don't have any, we just had two temperature gauges, so it's actually fine. Like, there we go. Stop it, and let's have a look, where's the way too many things? Let's get rid of that, let's get rid of that. So let's have a look. Give me KSC. The KSC is there, the runway is there. You know what, let's go for one more aggressive pass, and then we should land in, well, aggressive in terms of, I'm not going to do anything about keeping it straight. I'm just going to do, like, literally like this, SAS out, and inducing a spin. This we should slow down the maximum amount. So we're going to low Cuban orbit, that's more or less now the goal. OBS Studios. Actually, like I said, this is in the beginning, this is not my regular type of stream, so you can see here. So usually I'm not streaming the way that you could see anything apart from Kerbal Space Program or whatever I'm streaming. But right now you can see here, this is the stream chat. Things, watching, viewers, click rate, playbacks, everything. So, I wanted to show you, there you go, OBS Studios here. Oh, sorry about touching the microphone, my bad. And we are in a reasonably low orbit. Perfect, that's reasonable. Can go for a passive pass, I guess. And then we can... Oh, we could maybe aim for the desert runway in the next... Oh, we're already out of atmosphere. No, we're not. Then stop spinning in point retrograde, please. You feel it, okay. Let's hope. No, I'm going to give my best to avoid said tragedy. Tragedy. Perfect landing would be obvious in a KSC, but our inclined orbit is not quite is not really good for a KSC runway landing. So now 70. Let's go one more pass. Then passively we might actually be on a good approach. Nah. Orbital period's too long for a good approach for the runway, but maybe for this one here in two or three orbits. Now we're going to continue, like I said, on a slow approach, like continuing like this. We will lose altitude at perhaps this altitude, but not that high as in the previous one where we were spinning around. And by the way, guys, I'm quickly going to the bathroom, so I'm going to be back in 1 second. Well, 1 minute more or less. But in this time, I'm not going to do anything in it as well, so I'm just going to leave it like that. Be right back.
Keep real. The oldest son, he praised the Lord and married young, became a priest in that confession, cured the people of transgression. Gabriel, he held the weight of everybody's toxic waste, and with the load upon his shoulder, couldn't sleep as he got older. Oh, what it means to be someone that everybody has to talk to, everybody has to talk to. Oh, oh, Gabriel, he had no one that he could talk to. Gabriel, he had no one that he could talk to. Looking for a place to be or some place he could hide his grief, Gabriel ran to the beach and set out for the open sea. He the baggage from the sands, bore the vessel with his hands, and when he couldn't see the land, released their sins on his command. Oh, what it means to be someone that everybody has to talk to, everybody has to talk to. Oh, our Gabriel, he had no one that he could talk to. Gabriel, he had no one that he could talk to.
Here I am back, and we are already in space. Apologies for that. Crash? No, there's no crash here. Calm down, my friends. We are a bit too still higher than I expected we'd be, so I guess well, more or less the same thing. One more time, but this time I'm going to be at the very end of the, phew, exactly, no tragedy yet. And at the end of the pass, I'm going to do more maneuvers in order to bring us down. Well, the air perhaps is down by a substantial amount, and I would if things continue going this way, we might actually be able to land on the KSC runway once it is right here. Maybe no here. That would be dark. I don't like to land during the night. Because the desert runway, we already passed that opportunity. Have to wait too long. Going to quickly sip a bit of water. Yes, okay, you're right. We're not on the ground yet, and yes, everything Even suborbital speeds can tear this thing apart. Okay. Now that's the difficult question is, what should I aim for? The desert runway or the KSC? How are things looking here? Hot and toasty, brilliant. Let's just make you spin. Okay, that was enough spinning, otherwise we'll really lose the orbital velocity completely. Now let's go prograde. 900 kilometers up, that's good. We could aim for the desert runway. That's a good idea. Let's aim for the desert runway. We need to go... Are we already out of... Yeah, we're pretty much out of the atmosphere. Let's have a look. Do we have enough delta V remaining? Yes, we have. But it would be a bit of a, how should I say, close call, if I may say that. Case percent. At least they'll collect the melted remains and build a new ship. But there are no Kerbals on board. I wouldn't have more... What do you mean with more tea? More time? Landing in the desert. You wouldn't add more delta V to land on the desert. I mean, it could totally work out. Let's actually, where are we? We are here. Let's just time warp a tiny bit. Here, and make a quick save here. We totally are able to do that yet. Yes, quick save check. Now time for, no. Time for... Temperature, sorry. Well, that's not really a big difference because of the temperature. Now, the biggest problem I can see right now is that we're really, really fast, and if we were to... force, because we will force ourselves to land a lot faster in that regard. That's like the biggest problem I can see at the moment. Anyways, we have our... we've got our, how's it called? Maneuver node and quick save. So you're just going to be like, good luck with that. That's really on the last bit of fuel. Let's remove the maneuver node. Good, and now the remaining fuel going to be to the orbit right now. Let's hope that we'll have enough drag down. This will be an unpowered landing. Oh boy! I guess we'll need more than one attempt. That's it. Out of fuel. Yeah, they're slapping rockets together and somehow they work. That's a good approach, I like it. So, let's see, we have to lose speed. And frankly speaking, I'm really, 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 really nervous. I haven't been this nervous in a couple of missions in that regard, actually. Not in a couple of days, because I had something really important in real life coming up not too long ago, so yeah. Let's open up the no, not gonna open up the service bay, that's a bad idea. I'm now pointing below the speed mark because I want to drop altitude fast, since we're totally going to overshoot the way it looks right now. Not only the way it looks right now, we will overshoot since the runway is right in front of that big mountain there. I think. Yes. Now we're definitely going to come overshoot by a huge amount. Now you can see the runway down there. Come on! Okay, now we're flipping. That's not... was not quite planned. But maybe we'll slow down enough to land on it. That's the positive thing. Yeah, they are not good, but we're slowing down fast. That's good. Oh god, I have a bad feeling about this. Oh, we're right above the runway now. That's not gonna work. Okay, it doesn't look that bad actually. If we were to regain stability, control. If we were to regain control, then this thing would actually be able to land. But we don't, no. Let's wait a bit longer. And why were you still in orbital? Give me surface, thank you. No, that's not gonna work. That's a crash. Actually, points for you, Sergeant Matrix. You said it's not aerodynamically stable on re-entry. And yeah, you're right. Even though we have, give me quickly this, I just want to have a look at things. Even though we have the our ISRU in the very bit front, I mean, we could call this actually how not to land an orbital SSTO. This wing attack angle is just too much for it. Because during takeoff, that's exactly what it's good, but on landing, it's like... blonk! A big explosion. Anyways, second try. Wait just for the integration. Yeah. So, in that case, we're gonna keep a bit of fuel and just go through the atmosphere one more time to slow down and then just land somewhere else somehow. Let's have a look. No cover mode, no. SGS, yeah, that's exactly what I'm going to do next, since now we are back in orbit, as you can see, thanks to reloading, quick saving and reloading, always good. Because down there is the runway, you can see there. So we were not in a good approach for it. Wait, I have a terrible idea. That's such a terrible idea that I have here. This way we're being pushed down by the year. Wow, it's actually working! Unbelievable. Unbelievable that this is actually working the way I intended to. No way. Now we just have to be north. That's left from our perspective. That's just getting a bit toasty. That's the biggest issue. No, 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 no. It's not working. Okay. It's, even though I was trying to keep it right, really nice and progress through the entire passage, we're losing it. That's bad. So let's get 3, 2, and 1. There we go. Maybe we'll crash landing again. There's one more small thing that's not going to make a big difference, I know. So bringing the fuel forward is not going to make a big difference, since we pretty much have no fuel remaining anyways. So let's go. Well, oh, I can't heat. I hate it. We need more con- no, we need actually less wings. I know what the issue is. You can see if you look right, if it's flying straight for a second place. Come on, straight. I don't care what straight, but just straight. You can see that the wings are angled upwards, right? 5 degrees, like this. So this would be straight, but they're like that. That's in order to increase the lift. And right now, this increased lift is what makes this thing go flippy flippy. And this is a new technique. Well, new. Something I have never done in previous SSTOs. But this increases the amount of lift you gain during your ascent. So that's why playing around with it. So we are short of the runway here. Is the idea would then be kind of gliding down and just in the last moment slowing down for the runway there, but we can't even keep this one straight, it's just too much lift. They just produce too much lift, that's the problem. So we just can actually fall down and wait until we're down. Because there's no point in doing anything. Even if we pitch, kind of usually the best way to get out of a stall would be to pitch down like this. Ignite all engines, have enough thrust, and then control. But this is exactly working the opposite way. Getting more speed is bad for this, for our stability. Because with more speed, it will just flip down. Well, up. It depends which way you're looking. Just, well, pitching up. So that's why we'll never land this one. Let's still hit gear and brakes, even though that's useless. And try to make it just a soft crash landing. And blonk. Well, I wouldn't call that a soft crash landing, but it's the closest we can get to a soft crash landing. Come on, recover. There you go. You nailed it, Sergeant Matrix. You nailed it. Yeah, the problem is, I know what the problem is, I know what the solution to it is, but the question is if the plane will take off with said solution. Now this is the last thing I'm going to try, because actually I want to do something else. I have something to do. So just going to quickly check this one out and then finish the stream for today, since, well, actually I didn't plan to stream for, what is that right now, 1.5 hours. I actually plan just to make 40 minutes or something, just a tiny bit relaxing. And yeah, where is it? refuel SSD. Yeah, there we go. So we've got you. No, you. This will make it stable. I'm going to bet on it. But wait. Well, it will make it stable on landing, or at least more stable. Give me one of these, thank you. There we go. Save, takeoff, launcher. You have to go, it's dinner time. Okay. It's not made for space missions, but it definitely looks cool. So very, very much thanks for watching, and see you next time. And if you haven't subscribed, go and subscribe, please. I'd be really happy. So I'm going to quickly check this one, and then I'm going to end the stream as well, so you won't be missing on a lot. So don't worry. Copy that, I'm gonna do it. Oh, and now we actually have a Kerbal on board, brilliant. So now taking off prior to end of runway, not gonna work, but going to jump up this one and... Yes, it's working. Okay, perfect, that's fine. Let's give me this one. Drain rage. Drain entire vessel. You be skipping to this mode and you be like draining. Oh, we cannot drain anything. Okay, well, in that case, just waste my fuel like this. Or put some parachutes on top of it to help again. But then it kind of would defeat the purpose, so I'm not gonna go with parachutes. Oh wait, the other thing we have to do is going 5. We want to test you emptied. Opa! There we go. Just going to go really, really fast. Whoa, whoa, okay. 4 times regular speed is not good for a plane. But we do want to go 4 times regular speed in order to increase the rate at which we burn the fuel. Or we can just turn around, that's fine. That looks not too bad in terms of fuel drainage. Okay, it's flipping, that's not good, but I'm not doing any input, so that's not too bad. And, okay, up we go. Good recovery from that dive. Let's keep you prorate. Your stability by speed. Going to pitch you up a bit. Let's now go for a suborbital hop. What do you mean with no way? Yeah, I'm going to go for now a how's it called? Suborbital hop, and then we should more or less burn all our fuel on the way up there. Or at least I hope. Let's see how high are going. 50 kilometers out, perhaps. 57. Yeah, well, that's clear. I still have 200 units in this goddamn drain valve. I should have placed it on the tank and not back here. Didn't think about it not being able to drain through that cover thingy. So now we have to burn all the fuel the old-fashioned way, you know. Wait, what you got? Air combustion fan. Okay, actually that's perfect, even though I didn't want to say that, but that's perfect. I'm not gonna do anything right now. And prograding. Come on, stall out and pull down. Yes. No. Yes, come on. Okay, not looking good now. We have to really... Oh, wait, why do I have landing gear out? Oh, there we go, that's it. Yeah, medium atmosphere, kind of not good, but... lower atmosphere, it's working, but I can feel it, it's prone to flipping over. I should move the center of mass a bit further ahead, or the center of lift further back. Because now if I pull up too hard, it flips. And then we're back to square one. Well, apart the fact that we do know how to regain control. Just have to fly carefully, then it's fine. But we still have 2,000 units of liquid fuel. That's the other thing. Now, control surfaces are good. The problem is the center of lift is too far forward. So if we go landing... Let's land it here now as a nice, successful test flight. Okay, I don't think that's a good landing. A bit hard, just a tiny bit hard. Nah, good enough. Go back to this one. Yeah, exactly, the way you said it in the very, very beginning. You're totally right. Just a tiny bit. Yes, I'm going to Kenya this one, please. Thank you. I'm Protector. I love this song. So, let's have a quick look. Center of lift pointing down. Brilliant. Exactly. Let's move you a bit back. There we go. Let's move you to just a tiny bit back. Even though they're not that big of a deal, these additional wings here. These ones are clipping, that's not good. preferably moving the center of lift a bit forward. Wait, you cannot. Is it that small? Okay, come on again. There we go. Now I can see this one, please. Thanks and have a nice day. See you next time. Actually, one more thing I want to change is... More like a film that car. Okay, sounds good. I'll be your protector. Hello and welcome to the stream, K-Gun McCurdy. Ameno. I don't know what kind of language that is. Sorry about that, my friend. And I should maybe add an ing here. There you go. Speaking of canards, it was not a bad idea actually adding two canardies here in the very, very front. Just like that. There we go, that's good. I think we're gonna leave it the way it is right now and fly it in the next time, since that's the end of today's stream. What I just did actually is just moving this entire contraption, even though we were moving center of mass and center of lift, but primarily the center of lift, since all the wing surfaces are attached to this contraption, and this is the bigger center of mass. So if we move it a tiny bit together forward. Wait, did I move it forward? That makes actually no sense in every. Oh, yeah, exactly. The engines are being. If you move it back like this. I think having it back here makes actually more sense. From that perspective. Yeah, let's leave it here. No, just make it one tick towards the back. There you go. That's good enough. So that's it, and that's also it for today's stream. Thank you guys very, very much for watching, and until next time, Spaceship is going to sign out. Enjoy the rest of your day, my friends. Or evening, or whatever it is for you.